Every time we rehearse at John's house, he goes, "Hey man, check this out." And he adds like 15 new chords to all these songs. I go,
I like chords, I can't help it.
When did you?
It's an antiquated, it's an antiquated skill.
Getting back to my first question.
Are you interviewing me again?
Yeah, I'm trying to make this interesting for these people. Just kidding, come on. So you had a guitar teacher in Philly that turned you on to all that old music, right?
Well, yeah, I had an amazing guitar mentor, a guy named Jerry Ricks, who was unbelievable. And he actually was the tour manager for Mississippi John Hurt. So I would go to Jerry's house, and there would be Mississippi John Hurt sitting on his couch, or Doc Watson. And I got to learn a lot of the stuff directly from them. And that's, you know, where I get that other stuff from. And when Mississippi John Hurt passed away, his guitar that he played at the Newport Folk Festival in 1963 was given to Jerry. And then it was when Daryl and I started doing our first recordings in the early 70s in New York, I asked Jerry to play on those records, on our first two albums. And Jerry said to me, "Hey, you want me to bring Mississippi John's guitar for you to play on the session?" So on the first two Hall & Oates albums, the acoustic guitar I'm playing is Mississippi John Hurt's guitar. And and now I own that guitar again. So it's been an amazing musical journey to be able to reconnect with that, you know, the very, you know, kind of the earliest influences I had. Does that answer your question?
It's perfect.
Thank you.
Love that.
So speaking of that, you know what? Let's do a song from one of those albums.
Okay.
So this is from the Abandoned Luncheonette album, which came out in 1973. So it is actually one of my favorite, probably is my favorite Hall & Oates album. This is probably the last song I wrote in Philadelphia before moving to New York. And I did play it on the record on Mississippi John Hurt's guitar. But anyway, it goes something like this. Were you ever so in love you couldn't wait to get to sleep and dream about the one you wish was there beside you? In the past few days I've grown to love your giggles on the phone and how we hug so nicely. And from the first time that I saw you, had I known you better, said those three old words. And from the first time that I saw you, had I known you better then. Now I'm gonna move away, another town, another crazy day. I wanna stay and maybe hang around you. I call it luck, call it fate, call it a chance that we have met too late and loved too lightly. And from the first time that I saw you, had I known you better then, would have said those three old words. And from the first time that I saw you, had I known you better. Known you better than I can't believe that song's 50 years old. You know, 50 years ago, if somebody would have told me that I'd be in Nashville, Tennessee, playing something like this, I would never believed it in a million years. So, you know, it's been an incredible musical journey, and I'm just glad I can play and sing, and I really appreciate the fact that you guys still care enough to come out. So, yeah, thank you. Thank you.